Friends, it's 12th April and this is Sunday Times of India Delhi edition. In a first, Health Ministry reports over 1,000 new cases in a day. So friends, coronavirus is there in India and is going to be there in India for a long time to come. When I say long time to come, then you will think how many months or years. Nobody can say anything, but then just like polio virus, coronavirus is going to be a long drawn strategy where the war with corona will go on daily basis. The current strategy of lockdown all over the world has given good results, and so we are going to extend the lockdown as also said by various chief minister and our prime minister. Now the million dollar question is lockdown the solution? Everyone knows lockdown is not the solution. The solution lies in the karma or the work that we do during the lockdown. Like during the lockdown as seen in Rajasthan, which we call Bhilwara module, in Delhi, we are sealing certain hotspots, which the Delhi Chief Minister has said it has shield. He has given analogy of shield, wherein shield stands for isolation, screening, and so on. You have read it always. My point is not that. My point is, during the lockdown, we need to work 24/7. Just like China and any other country, we are using technology like drones. Our law and order agency is also working. Everyone is working, but as I will turn the pages of the newspaper, you will find that there are certain challenges also coming that I'll unfold you in front of you. So the point is, we have done very good job by putting our country into lockdown and slowing the spread of disease. But my dear friends, the battle has just begun. The war is going to be a long drawn, and the war is going to be with the infection of coronavirus, as well as what we say in Darwin's theory, that is called the survival of the fittest. So we are not only going to survive just by controlling the infection. My dear friends, India is a developing country. Already the GDP was going down before this coronavirus episode. Our industry was just coming up from the deep shock. Our GDP was slightly improving. We were just on the upside, started upside. Not on the upside, but we had started going up and this problem has come. So we need to fight the infection as well as look after our economy. So I'm not going into very point wise, but I'm going to tell you what I've heard from various media and in this newspaper. I looked at the interview of Mr. Gadkari. He was saying with a media person that now ports are working 24/7. There is no full stop or comma over there. They are working as it is, the way they have been working before. So our ports are working 24/7. Highways are going to remain open, national highways. So as far as logistics are concerned, trucks and other vehicles carrying essential goods and important things can always move without any issue, without any problem. Even our FICCI and Indian Commerce of Chambers of Commerce Industries and other various federation representing the industry have talked to our ministries, respective ministries, and they have drawn out a plan, though it is not into the media and public, but things like they are going to work in a way wherein they will deploy only 50% of their labor in two shifts. Something like if a factory is having 100 workers, 50 workers can work for first half of the month, then another 50% of the workers can work for the second half of the month. So this way they can divide into two or three batches, and condition is they will be tested first, number one. Then other condition is the industry will have to provide facility just like the way government is providing to the healthcare workers, wherein khana, peena, lodging, boarding, everything will be within that industrial complex so that people don't have to move out, and social distancing will be maintained sacrosanct. So social distancing cannot be compromised. That's the important thing. So other thing that is coming up is the country can be divided into three zones: red, yellow and green. Red zones are those where there are hotspots and containment will be there. There are another term that is emerging is locked in. One term you have all heard of is that is lockdown. Other term that is coming is lock in. That means you are within the within your own house. You cannot even move out of your house. You should not. You should not come into the premises of your society flats wherein people are moving, playing within that society complex. So you have to be within the four walls of your house. That's it. That is called lock-in. So red zone will be like that. Yellow zone, people can move in a restricted way and can go out for grocery and vegetables. And green will be just like any other normal working days where people can do their normal chores of life and business. So that's how things are going to move. So now an important term that is coming from the Prime Minister is, earlier we were saying Jaan hai to Jahan hai, which in Hindi means if there is life you can enjoy the world. Now the strategy that is going to work out from 15th of April to 30th of April is Jaan bhi Jahan bhi. That means life as well as a world. When we say as well as a world, it means place where we live in. Like I live in Delhi, so I want to see that Delhi continues to be a prosperous state. Our people of Delhi continue to have good lifestyle. It also means to whole of India, which means our industry should prosper, everybody should have jobs, everybody who is owning the industry, whether I am a shareholder or whether I am an employee, everybody should continue to get their pie of prosperity that we used to get earlier. So it doesn't mean that if you are alive, but if you do not have jobs, if you do not have our assets, then also it won't be a very happy situation. So we have to protect our assets, our businesses, our jobs, so do the life. So that's what it means. Now what is emerging is that Prime Minister is talking to various chief ministers, and whatever is happening is with the consensus, with the planning. So as a word, every ministry, every business, industrial houses are coming out with their plan, blueprint, how they are going to work, and bureaucrats from the government will okay the plan, and that's how things will move. So if the government is satisfied that the industry will work in a way wherein norms like social distancing and health of the employees are maintained, they will go ahead, get a go ahead. Now ordinance to stop new insolvency cases for 6 months. As we know, with the kind of epidemic we are going through, many industries will turn into losses. So we'll have to change the rule of the game, and for 6 months we'll have to be with a different rules of the game. Now another thing I want to share with you is, like in this paper front page, Faridabad hospital doctors
protest lack of PP. So even in healthcare scenario, healthcare workers are the frontline warriors right now. But then in various hospitals, forget this Faridabad, complaints are coming of lack of personal protective equipment. And there are also cases wherein, like in this case, they have alleged, like they say, they have alleged senior doctors of the hospital have stayed away from COVID-19 duties. Now, I am a doctor myself and I am in touch with so many doctors. Even doctors are afraid. They also love their life. They not only love their life, but they also want their family members to survive. Because when you are a doctor yourself, there are always chances of not only you getting sick, but when you go home, there are chances that you will carry the infection home. So at times you are under a lot of pressure from your family members, parents and spouses and children. At times even forcing them to leave the job. So things are not easy. And as mentioned here, many seniors in the hospital are not coming, but the juniors are being asked to work. So this is also a very pathetic situation that we do encounter in not only this hospital, but many other hospitals too, be it any. So things are ugly everywhere. Even in Delhi, there have been cases wherein doctors have got good facility, but then the nurses, like in LNJP, I've heard the sisters asked and now they have been accommodated in Gujarat Bhavan because the facilities where the hostel was given to nurses was not appropriate as per them. So like thrown into the battle without even enough cover. So these are the stories of the doctors, and now these are the hospitals wherein healthcare workers have faced the brunt. Delhi State Cancer Institute, Dilshad Garden, Maharaja Krishna Hospital, Punjabi Bagh, Gangaram Hospital, Karol Bagh, Delhi, Apollo, Sartavyar, Ames, Ansari Nagar, Sadarjung Hospital, Sardar Vallabhbhai Hospital, Patel Nagar, Mulchand. So, and you can see the number of staff that have been turned positive. The highest number in Delhi State Cancer Institute, followed by Agrasen Punjabi Bagh. So, as of now, 35 healthcare workers have been found positive in Delhi itself. And look at the number of people who have been quarantined. It's a huge number, 340 positive. Similarly, Bombay, Jaslok, Beach Candy Hospital, Bhatia, and Khar Hinduja Hospitals are private hospitals in Mumbai that have been affected by spread of COVID-19 among the healthcare workers. So things are ugly everywhere. Among public hospitals in Mumbai, several staffers from KM, Sion, Bhava hospitals have been taken off rosters. So, even in Delhi, if you see the bulletin of Delhi Health Government, so as far as isolation is concerned, LHJP is working fine, but when it comes to ICU kind of things, RML has only one patient which is in ICU. When it comes to patients on ventilator, so COVID patients on ventilator can be seen mostly in private hospitals in Delhi. Not many COVID patients are on ventilator in government hospitals. In government hospitals, the ICU, number of beds in ICU are less, and that too when it comes to ventilator support, that is where in the private pitch in. Even now, if you see the Delhi bulletin, you will come to know a lot many things. So there is a difference in the kind of care you get in government hospitals and in private hospitals. So when the patient is turning sick, becoming critical, and that too when you need the ventilator, that is where the private hospital is better than the government hospital. And the Delhi health bulletin says so. So COVID patients in Delhi in on ventilator, they are more in private hospitals than in government hospitals. This is one of the pick in Times of India wherein
people have been locked in and showing a very surprising look from a door. Now, even healthcare workers, like those who are doing sanitation jobs, like ward boys and workers from the municipality who are working in the containment zone. Now, this is one of the pick of a guy who is just 10th pass matriculate, Mantosh Kumar. He was not allowed from his home to go out. His family member asked him to leave the job. But then he wore the hazmat suit and is working. He was under constant pressure from his family not to go to work. He said, no, I'm working in a very critical job and he need to go. My family asked me not to do this dangerous work. Sometimes I do get scared and anxious. So even doctors are under pressure from their family. Now, with respect to containment zone, my dear friends, yesterday night, as on 11th April, there were 27 zones. In the morning of 12th April, it was 30. And today, 12th April, by lunch, I remember it was 33. So 33 zones were there during afternoon today. A dog turns ambulance driver, saves newborn life. At times, situation in India are sometimes pathetic, as you would have seen many videos wherein a lady in Bihar was carrying her son and she couldn't even get an ambulance, any vehicles, my dear friends. So things are pathetic sometimes. We talk so much, but then when it's time of need, you don't get anything. Now you can see this article also, why parts of India can't ramp up COVID testing. Now, my dear friends, we all know that more we do test, the earlier we'll get the curve flattened. So number of testing should increase, but the bottleneck is the number of laboratories that can do the PCR test, RT-PCR test. So the problem is we don't have so many laboratories in India. Now, Chennai has city of Chennai, that is Madras, has 8 laboratories wherein you can take the COVID sample, but the whole of Rajasthan has 8. So one city of Chennai on one side and whole state of Rajasthan on one side. But then things are even worse when it comes to rest of India. Like Bihar is having only 4 laboratories like this. Jharkhand has only just 2. The highest number of labs are in Bombay, which has 29. So 29 labs in Mumbai can do the testing. Because there are a lot of things goes into making a laboratory. So what a new testing center must have: molecular biology setup for virology diagnosis, functioning and calibrated biosafety cabinet, an enclosed safe space to safely work with the pathogens, cold centrifuge or microfuge for RNA extraction, RNA genetic
real-time PCR machine polymerase chain reaction, which makes millions of copies of staff already trained in handling samples. So apart from infrastructure, you need staff also to be trained for that. Well-defined policy to deal with biomedical waste. So these are the bottleneck things. You can't establish a laboratory like that. So as I told you, dear friends, the government has allowed farmers to do the harvesting, but they bring all their harvesting things to the mandi, so their social distancing norm will be broken. So the government has asked to go to the farmers and buy the things and not let the farmers come to the mandi. So their products will be purchased from the farmland itself. There are also indications, as I told you, economic activity to start in a graded way. Though they say trains and flights will not start soon, but as a doctor, I feel even we as healthcare workers, doctors, nurses, we are going to hospitals. But if we take certain precautions, we can manage the show. Especially airlines can do manage the show. If the aircraft is just one third or half filled, we can manage the show. So sanitize the aircraft before taking the passengers and after taking the passengers. So as I told in my earlier video, we can have one flight per sector in the whole day, and the things should work in a package way. In a way, like, suppose a person is coming from a state which is locked down and is by chance going to a city which is also locked down. So the ticket must include the fare, which is inclusive of the pick and drop facility. So if all passengers must be picked by the airlines company itself from their homes, it can be by a bus or car, they should be brought to the airport where they need to be screened, sanitization, so many things, papers, Aadhaar card, because we need to have the address, suppose if things go wrong. And those who are giving a sick look, fever or something, they should not be allowed to board the plane. So they need to report to the airport at least 2 hours in advance. Then they board the airport, aircraft, provided things are okay. Then at the destination, the bus takes them to their respective houses. So where even if the city is locked down, because they will not get the taxis, but then they reach home safely. So how this is how the aviation should work nowadays under the current circumstances. Government has allowed marine fishing industries from these restrictions. I should also mention this, stuck between visa and corona worries. My dear friends, they are the faces of few doctors who are working in America. They are in Dharam Sankat, sort of in a very typical situation. Like, I will narrate you a story. It is of a Deepika Gupta, doctor who is in America. She says, but the present immigration policies give them a raw deal. If these health workers, usually on H-1B or J-1 visa, fall sick, they risk losing their jobs. If they die, their families can be deported. Dr. Deepika Gupta, a hospitalist working in a hospital treating COVID patients in Spokane County, Washington, knows the risks she takes every time she dons her scrubs. She says, every time I walk into the hospital, I tell myself I cannot fall sick. I cannot die. I live in the constant fear that I may be asked to leave, says a 35-year-old who moved to the US from Dehradun some 10 years ago. Things are pathetic. Even I will tell you in other page, the number of people, healthcare workers dying in US, most of them are blacks or from Asia. So the doctors from Asia, India, working in UK are dying more in numbers than rest of the doctors. This is also one of the very sparkling kind of story. I cannot digest it, being a doctor myself.
See, fear rise in UK that ethnic minorities more prone to coronavirus. Concerns have been raised about the number of ethnic minorities contracting COVID-19. Dayton after report found that a disproportionate number of these patients in intensive care who test positive are for the disease were from Black, Asian and ethnic minority. So the Blacks in UK, Asians, we Indians and the ethnic minority are dying more in number in UK than others. A report by Intensive Care National Audit and Research Center found that up to 3rd of April 2020, of the 1,966 patients admitted to critical care with COVID-19, 35% were non-white, which is nearly double the average population of UK. So more Blacks, more Asians are dying in UK than the those who are from UK itself. So friends, that was it.